Hello mortals. Biology. A beautiful field of mathematics where division and multiplication are the same thing. Since we're doing bad biology jokes, do you know what does DNA stand for? National Dyslexics Association. Enough cringe, let's get started. The foundation of biology stands on four big pillars: cell theory, evolution, genetics and homeostasis. The cell theory implies that all living things are composed of cells, and that all cells arise through cell division. These little building blocks are able to grow, produce proteins, divide, multiply and other cool stuff thanks to metabolism, the process of converting food into energy and building materials. One of the cell's main function is to store data of the organism they're part of. Here comes genetics, and our sponsor acknowledgement. Save 15% on your first order of the Raycon wireless earbuds by following this link, available in the description. This data is stored in a special molecule called DNA. The unit of memory in a DNA molecule is the gene, which is way cooler than those pathetic bits of any hard drive. In a single gram of DNA, you could store 215 petabytes or 215 million gigabytes. For reference, to store all of the videos from YouTube you would need 320 petabytes of storage, or a gram and a half of DNA, still not enough for the new Call of Duty update. The information stored in the DNA is used for assembling new proteins and dictate how an organism will look like and function. After cell division, the DNA is copied in the new cell. But there is a small chance that the replication will not go as planned and some genes will be altered. In this case we have a mutation, which is able to change some characteristics of the organism and its offspring. These new traits could be favorable and make the organisms more likely to survive and thus produce more offspring, while specimens with unfavorable mutations go extinct. This principle is called natural selection and it constitutes the key mechanism of evolution. And the last one is homeostasis, which represents the ability of maintaining a certain equilibrium of physiological processes in living systems for an optimal function of organs and cellular processes. This balance is maintained by many regulatory mechanisms which perceive some perturbations from outside, and react to them. For example, mammals have the ability to regulate their core temperature in response to the low outside temperature, in order to keep their organs working and not freeze to borderline death, like how the majority of dumbass amphibians do. For something to be classified as a living being, it must be composed of cells, be able to maintain homeostasis, undergo metabolism, have a life cycle, be able to grow, adapt to the environment and reproduce. The stuff that is considered alive is classified in five kingdoms: bacteria, protista, fungi, plants and animals. There are more systems of classification, but this one is the most popular. Bacteria are single-celled organisms with a simple internal structure that lack a nucleus, and contain DNA that just freely floats inside. They were one of the first forms of life to appear on Earth and thus evolved to live in water, soil, acidic hot springs, radioactive waste, and inside other organisms. And while some of them are helpful for digestion, certain species of bacteria are responsible for diseases like tuberculosis or the bubonic plague. Their size typically varies between 1 and 5 micrometers in length. However, there are a few species that are visible to the unaided eye, like the Thea margaritinibiensis, which can reach up to a millimeter in size. The other types of organisms actually have a nucleus in which they responsibly store their DNA, and are called eukaryotes. The most simple eukaryotes are the protists, which is actually a very wide term for every unicellular organisms that have a nucleus and cannot form any tissues. The best they can do is to form colonies and help each other survive, like how the algae do. Eventually, some protista which were able to turn sunlight into energy evolved into plants, multicellular organisms that are able to photosynthesize. I'm sure you've seen a plant at least once in your life. If not, you probably haven't evolved eyes yet. All in all, Plants are pretty boring and I'll just add their classification into ferns, mosses, conifers and flowering plants. Fungi are like the weird cousin of plants and animals. They tend to stay in place like plants but do not have the ability to photosynthesize. That means they have to get organic carbon from other sources, like plant or animal matter, instead of producing it from anorganic carbon molecules, just like animals. An individual characteristic of fungi is the presence of chitin in their cell walls. This kingdom consists of yeasts, molds, and, well, shrooms. And the last and the most epic one, animals. For only 46 and 99 evolution points, you will get the ability to start your life from a blastula, which will allow you to develop specialized tissue and organs later on in the game. Also, forget about producing organic material from anorganic sources like air and light because, as an animal, you will get your nutrients from others' organic material. Are you getting bored of being stuck in dirt your entire life? Worry no more, because animals have special locomotory mechanisms to move and get to places using fins, tentacles, or an absurd amount of legs. And if you get lucky enough, you'll get even more complex organs like eyes, liver or even an ink sac. And if you win the evolution lottery, you will get a brand new, and overpowered, big brain. Try it right now and you'll get an appendix for free. Besides the aforementioned types, there are also viruses, viroids, prions, and AI, which are not considered life forms by scientists, mostly because of their inability of making the sex. All these kingdoms are further divided into phyla, classes, orders, families, genera, and species. For example, if we take the Animalia kingdom, Chordata phylum, class of bony fishes, Tetradonta forms order, Tetraodontidae family, Ephippian genus, you'll find the prickly puffer fish. As an area of science, biology branches into multiple subdisciplines like cytology, which will teach you what the powerhouse of a cell is, biochemistry, which studies the chemicals reaction that occur inside the said cells, anatomy, which shows you how much does each of your organs cost, genetics, the study of genomes, paleontology, the study of prehistoric life, ecology, the interaction of living beings with the environment, botany, zoology, mycology, the study of plants, animal and fungi respectively. There also are even more interesting subjects like astrobiology, the study of the origin and the future of life in the universe, bioinformatics, the analysis and interpretation of biological data. And then there's quantum biology, the study of international relations in the South Pacific during the 90s. You're probably wondering why do I wear earbuds if I don't have ears? To that, I say that some questions should be left unanswered. If you want top-of-the-line sound quality and not waste your life savings on overpriced products, the Raycon earbuds offer a premium sound experience at half the price compared to any other options on the market. Their Everyday E25 earbuds are their best model yet, with 6 hours of playtime and 24 hours of additional battery from the charging case. Do you love bass as much as I do? You'll love them too. They're perfect for you. Wow, I just started rapping by simply wearing them. Not bad, Raycon. Great for working from home, working out, and listening to music and podcasts for hours on end, and they come in a variety of colors. Access the link by raycon.com/sciencefile from the description and save 15% on your first order.